Hello everyone, welcome to the 12th video of the data analytics and visualization series. Today we're going to look at density plots, right? So what is a density plot? A density plot is essentially a smoothened version of a histogram. So we saw how to plot a histogram in the previous video, in video number 11. We're just going to use almost the same type of syntax. There's not too much changes, but the only difference is in a histogram you will have you can actually see the distribution across a numerical variable, which is usually plotted on the x-axis, and you will get the count of the observations on the y-axis. In the density plot, it's going to be exactly the same. The only difference is instead of the count, you will get something like a density, right? So you don't need to read too much into it. All that you need to understand is it's a smoothened curve for a histogram. And also, after you look at the plain vanilla, and then when we start looking at a slightly more interesting versions of the density plot, you can see that how multiple density plots can be overlapped and how you can see them and observe them visually, right? So let's get straight into the action. We'll run the first line of code. It looks like this. Here we have flipped the coordinates. So whatever we see on the y-axis was actually x-axis. And the distribution here, I mean, the way to read it is you will have, you can see a significant number of cars were launched in 2008 and in 1999, which is towards the bottom part of the y-axis. And then you can see that very few cars were launched somewhere between 2002 and 2004, right? So getting onto the code, it's a simple code, ggplot. You will call on the dataset MPG. The MPG is the same dataset that we've been using, different types of cars and their attributes. Again, like histogram, we are going to have only the x-axis here. So x is equal to year, and we are going to use geom density as the plot instead of geom underscore histogram. Inside the geom density, we're just calling out the color that we need. So here it's a variant of green and the alpha indicator, which tells you what kind of transparency you need. So the closer to zero, more transparent, closer to one, more deep, right? So I hope this is fairly easy to understand. Let's get onto the next plot. I'll just run the plot. And then I'll try and explain how it looks. It is a two variable plot. You can see that one of the plots is above the x-axis, and the second density plot is below the x-axis, right? So what is happening here? So in the first plot, which is above the x-axis, the blue plot, it is actually a density plot for the highway miles per gallon. And the bottom plot, which is the orange plot, is that for city miles per gallon. Now, this is this kind of plot is used generally to understand two relatively comparable numerical variables, right? So in both these plots, we're trying to compare mileage. The blue one is the highway mileage, and the bottom one is the city mileage. So you can see that city mileage is usually lesser compared to the highway mileage, which is expected. And you can also see proportions, right? You can see more number of observations being stuffed into somewhere between 14 and 17 or 18 mileage for city miles per gallon. Most number of cars give you that, but if you take cars onto the highway, you can see a far more wider range, and you don't see too many observations at one particular, so you'll have a more broader range, right? So I hope if you want to just do a quick two variable comparison, both are numerical variables, and you want to see how one is trending with respect to the other, both in terms of range and in terms of how it's how you get the spikes, you can do this. So here you can see a double humped highway miles per gallon split compared to a relatively single hump city miles per gallon. Right, and how do you write this code? Right, you simply use a geom density, and here in the x-axis you're calling the highway, and you add another plot where in the x-axis you're calling CTY, right? And in the y-axis you're just going to write dot dot density dot dot, right? So this is so that it understands that you will need to have two plots. And you're going to fill it with blue, and the second one you're going to fill it with orange. And just so that people understand what is on the top and what is on the bottom, you'll simply use the geom label and mention, and this is where you sequence it, right? You will say x is equal to 4, y is equal to 0.1, which is how you would sequence it on the axis. And you just mention the label as hwy, right? So you can see in this, the label is slightly towards to the right of x is equal to 0, and you have started placing it at the right y, right? So if you want to if you want to place it elsewhere, you just need to move things around, right? So here, the only thing that you need to observe is you need to have a negative on the y so that the CTY sits to the bottom. Cool. So that's about it for the second graph. Let's quickly look at graph number 3. Right. What are we seeing here? Here we are using, we are looking at multiple values of the class variable here, and we are seeing different types of density plots. And you can see the overlaps here because you're trying to control this through your density argument, through your alpha argument, right? So let's look at the code. You're using the MPG variable, your x-axis is equal to HWY. You're grouping it by class and filling it by class. So it's fairly simple. And in the geom density, you're putting your adjust and alpha indicators just to control your transparency and how you want to do that overlap, right? So I hope this is also fairly simple. Let's look at the next plot. Right. So you would have seen normal bar graphs, and you would have seen the 100% bar graphs in Excel sheet, right? So this is also fairly similar. So if you want to see what proportion of your pickups or SUVs belong to different types of how do they comprise different intervals of a numerical variable, you can actually use this plot. Right. So how do I read this plot? You can see that your pickup cars, they have lower highway miles per gallon, most of them, right? You'll see that there is a thick or there is a high percentage of pickups falling in the lower than 20 miles per gallon bracket. Similarly for SUVs. Now there are some SUVs which get into over 20, and most of pickups are fairly less than 20. So you can see that small tapering off of the brown region, right? You see two-seaters are fairly between 20 and 25. So is minivans. In the light blue section, you see how your mid-size cars move. They have a wider range, but fewer proportion. You can see your compact and subcompact are the cars with both a wider range and higher mileage. Right. So if you want to do 100% graph, right, if you want to just see what proportion of different types of car types or values of a particular variable move within a particular data distribution, you can use this graph. Right. So let's quickly get into the syntax. It's exactly the same syntax. The only thing that you're doing here is you're mentioning the position is equal to fill. That's all that it distinguishes a normal density plot from a stacked 100% density plot, right? And lastly, we have been already looking at faceting in the previous videos. I'll just quickly show you a quick video of how to facet the density plot graph. Here you can see I'm using the same density plot argument, and in the end I'm just doing a facet underscore wrap with a tilde and class, right? So this is what you see. You see like a histogram, a smoothened histogram across different car types, and you can see how they spike at different mileages, right? So you can see your pickups and SUVs spiking early, whereas your compact and subcompacts spiking slightly later. So this actually tells you how your different car types are sequenced. What's the height of a spike? Is it what's the range of a particular variable? So on and so forth, right? So these are kind of interesting graphs. If you want to try out the density plot, it's a good alternative to the histogram. If you don't really want to look at the count side of things, but you want to play around, you want to show overlaps, you want to play around with transparency. It's really cool for the visualization bit. Hope this was okay. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you on the next video. Thank you.